Hey, everyone, and welcome to On the Fly, America Walked Her. Devin Dubnyk will join me in just a moment. A light two-game slate on Monday, but we start with heavy playoff implications in St. Louis. The Blues have won six of their last seven and entered Monday just 4 points behind the Golden Knights for the second Western Conference wildcard spot. St. Louis has played one more game than Vegas, making Monday's head-to-head matchup with VGK even more crucial to the Blues' playoff hopes. Meanwhile, Vegas seems to have found their game, winning five of their last seven contests, but the road to the playoffs won't be easy for the defending champs. Monday kicks off a four-game road trip that will see the Golden Knights travel to St. Louis, of course, then Nashville, Winnipeg, and Minnesota. Let's get out to Enterprise Center with a huge 2 points on the line.
Blues have been playing some excellent hockey as of late. They're 6-1-0 in their last seven games. This is the must-win game of the season, though. It doesn't get any bigger than this.
Both teams understand what's at stake here tonight.
Four-point cushion on the Blues. This is as big a game as they have played in this regular season.
Dorfiev gets it back. Walker goes down trying to play the puck. Mantha keeps it alive. Dorfiev down low. Cuts in front and scores! Goals in three straight for the first time in his career for Pavel Dorofeev. And the Golden Knights strike first in St. Louis.
What a move to the net. And Dorofeev just takes it to the goal mouth and able to get it past Binnington.
And six goals in his last 10. Zod racing in. Like a big hit from McNabb in the corner. Zod shaking up. Shin goes after McNabb. And a fight here. Shin a solid right on McNabb. Meanwhile, Saad was injured there, and Shin protecting his teammate. And this is a pretty good scrap here.
That McNabb's a big boy, Braden Shin. Not only did he handle himself there, he let it be known that he's the sheriff around here.
Tight checking first period, and it ends with the Knights up by one. And Sundquist in the corner. He's injured. He'll need attention. Not sure what happened to him. He made a pass around Jamie, and it might have been McNabb again who, of course, rocked Saad in the first period.
And he gets hit a little bit of the blind side.
And that right leg buckled a bit.
He goes in, he tries to plant that leg.
Yeah, not putting a lot of weight on the right leg.
Yeah.
That is not good to see. And a big part of this team on and off the ice. By the way, Sundquist will not return with a lower body injury. With Nick Leddy. To Leddy, short-handed, in the clear. And a save by Thompson on Leddy. Really a short-handed goal. The Blues have 11 this year.
Hits 23 miles an hour on this year. It's a little bit of a hook there. Thompson does a good job of keeping that leg with it. Bench certainly not happy there. Thought there should have been a penalty.
That's it for the period. And it's Kevin Hayes up ice. Kevin Hayes in alone. And a save Thompson. Hayes trying to tuck that in. One-handed on the backhand. And Thompson with the split of the left hand.
What a save by Logan Thompson.
Puck loose to Thomas. Buchnevich. Krug with a chance. That's off the crossbar. No red light. Off the crossbar and out. And it stayed out.
Well, Logan Thompson made the huge save earlier. This time some help from his crossbar.
Going to make a clean play. He does to Shin. Back in front. They score! Saad tips it in. Mr. Minkall has done it again. It's 1-1.
Jordan Carter creates the turnover. Nice little dish. And Braden Shin with a fantastic backhand pass to Brandon Saad. Look at this, driving the net right there, right past Shea Theodore. Strong on the stick.
And guess what? We're going to overtime. Trying to go up the middle. He does. In the clear. Pulled down. Penalty. Maybe a penalty shot. I think it will be. A penalty shot for Buchnevich. One-on-one against Logan Thompson. Saad Thompson with a glove to keep the Golden Knights alive in this game. He flashed the leather on Buchnevich. Double teamed in deep. Marchessault digs it out. Marchessault looking. Shot score! Jonathan Marchessault off the post and in. His 39th of the season. Wins it in overtime. 2-1.
Talked so many times you need a big goal. Who is it? Number 81.
I think it was just a classic hard work from Carly in the corner. He had two guys around him, so I was just trying to go support him. And I didn't want to force that to Shea there. That D was kind of fading off. So I just, I know he's a goalie that kind of challenged. Under gloves normally are open. And yeah, I got lucky. Tonight we didn't give up a lot of chances. And obviously when we give them, Logan was awesome. So I mean, for us, we keep moving, and we look what's the challenge ahead of us.
You know, we've been through a lot this year, a lot of ups and downs, and I think we owe it to ourselves to give ourselves a chance, and we knew what was at stake tonight, and this was an important one for us. And like I said, we got one here, and now we have to move on and take care of business and hopefully get some help. So as long as we do our job, that's all we can ask, and I think the guys are focused on that.
So Jonathan Marchessault with the overtime game winner powered by Energizer. Last year's Conn Smythe Trophy winner knows a thing or two about coming up clutch. Marchessault's OT winner against the Blues was his eighth as a Golden Knight, surpassing Shea Theodore for the most overtime goals in Golden Knights history. So, Doobie, definitely an exciting finish there. Incredible overtime session. And obviously, we got to talk about just that series. Logan Thompson making the epic save on the penalty shot. And then 19 seconds later, it's Marchessault with that overtime winner.
Yeah, as a goalie, you love to see that. The momentum change. What a save. The flair. Got the boys going on the bench. You can see the excitement out of the group. And that's a great save, too. That's a good little shot. You see, well, speak of the devil, this overtime goal goes right in that same low glove spot. But yeah, big momentum swing, huge save there by Thompson. Actually a great save if you watch the replay on the initial penalty shot call. I think he gets a toe on that puck. I was surprised that puck didn't go in the net. So two big ones from Logan Thompson and plenty other ones in the game.
Yeah, you love that. That's that goalie high for you. But the flair, too, I think that was fun to, yeah,
that's
to see there on the
boys excited.
That
you
is.
Saw the bench.
And, yes. And it paid off. It just, again,
it
19
matters.
Seconds later, just a lot of fun there. And obviously a very important game for both of these two teams. And Vegas will be looking a lot to Logan Thompson. Obviously, Aiden Hill dealing with another injury again. He did not travel on this road trip. And he got it done, 30 saves, you mentioned. Some of them were huge throughout the night.
Yeah, he wasn't busy at the start, but the chances that he had, he was making huge saves. There were really good low coverage in the net, but they are going to lean on him here. And Vegas, we're used to seeing, obviously, we talked a lot about many different goalies and sharing the net a lot.
Sure.
But, Logan Thompson's going to have an opportunity here to really make a big difference like he did tonight, and they're going to need him in this playoff race. And if he can continue to do what he did tonight, then they're going to be in a great spot. But like I said, there wasn't a ton of chances in the first half of the game, and then he got some more as the game went on, and obviously the big few shots that he had earlier on, there were some tough ones, and he made some huge saves to keep Vegas up 1-0 as the game went on and almost stopped the tying goal as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And they did tack on another save for him too, so boosting up his numbers a bit. 31 saves on the night in a big win for VGK. We're just getting started here on the fly after the break. With the Blues loss, the Canucks would be the first team to punch their ticket to the playoffs. That's if they can beat the Kings. We've got highlights from Vancouver next. Welcome back to On the Fly. Let's get to Vancouver for Kings Canucks.
Imagine before the season someone would have told you the Vancouver Canucks would be the first team in the league with a chance to hit 100 points and secure a playoff berth. Well, that's where we are.
Back on the left side where it's chipped to the Kings line, but no deeper by Besser. The other way, here comes Dubois down to the right circle to the net, feeds it across, shot, score! Great setup by P.L. Dubois.
And I think the Canucks got confused and have skaters on the ice.
Yeah, this is the neutral zone turnover,
and they did only have four skaters.
Four players and then a player trying to get off the bench. It was the Lotto line that was out for the tail end of that power play.
Here's Lafferty, power move in front, gets right in, scores! And Lafferty ties his career high and ties the game in one.
1-1 here, not a lot of room for scoring chances. Especially here in the second period. Myers up top, a drive, kick down, rebound, save off Mikhaev. Best save of the game for Cam Talbot.
Great positioning, resetting on the play.
Tied at one. Canucks turn it over. Deneau leaves it for Lewis. Lewis moves in, got upended. Going to be a penalty on Soucy. Delayed call. Kings have pulled the goalie. Circle Spence. Cross ice feed, shot pass, block, score! Goes in off a skate. Lewis might get credit for it, but the Kings on the delayed penalty have regained the lead at 2-1.
Well, certainly Trevor Lewis started by drawing the penalty.
Blake Lizotte getting credit for the goal that goes in off Soucy. Hands it off Kopitar down to the right circle. Shot, save, rebound, loose, score! Kopitar knocks it off. Kopitar has given the Kings a 3-1 lead.
Here's Roy. He's got Lizotte going to the net. There's the pass. He's in. Stopped by the glove of Casey DeSmet. Blake Lizotte looking for his second of the game. A nice move to the backhand. But DeSmet had the answer to that. Canucks pull the goalie here. This is aggressive. JT Miller to the blue line. Quinn Hughes. Here's Besser again. Slap pass. On the skate.
Ten seconds left. Roy up the wall. Held in Hughes. Feeds it across. Pettersson for Miller. Shot pass. Block. Kings with it. And the game is over.
Yeah, I felt like one. Good start. I mean, they came on off hot. And I feel like we adapt a little bit after first one. And got some goals in. And in the end, it was tight again, you know. So it was a good game overall. Well, there's always, playoff is a new season, you know, so it doesn't really matter what happens in the regular season. But of course, if we can win those games, we're going to do it, you know, and we're going to do everything in our power to try to do so.
All right, so with the wins by both the Kings and Golden Knights, the Western Conference playoff picture remains the same after Monday night's games. The Blues did manage to get a point in their OT loss, but are now 5 points back of Vegas for that second wild card spot, with their playoff hopes quickly slipping away. All right, Doobie, so another good one. Obviously, Kevin Fiala there just talking about feeling like a playoff-type game, and that's what we got in both of these games tonight, because that's the time of year. That's what you want to get your game to, and it really felt like it down the stretch as Vancouver made that big push.
Yeah, and there's something to be said about that, because you don't know. I mean, you look at those standings, and anything can happen. Anybody could be playing anybody at this point. But for two games on the slate, those are pretty good, essentially, playoff games. But he's right, and the thing is when you play a team, when you come up against a team in playoffs, you want to be able to have a good feeling, either whether it's in your building or the other building. So, you know, maybe this game isn't a playoff game, but if you come into if you end up playing Vancouver in the playoffs, you want to have that feeling in their building, like you can go in there and win a game and just have that. And it matters, because if you go up against a team, even if you're close in points, but, you know, maybe they've had your number that year, it's not a good feeling going into a playoff game or playoff series when you feel like you can't go into that team's building and win a game. So this is big for LA.
Yeah, I'm sure that boost goes a long way to your point there. Let's talk a little bit more about the winning LA Kings. Of course, Andre Kopitar, got to give him a little love as he extends his multi-point streak to 4 games, which matches a career high. Also notches 40 assists, something he's done quite often in his career. Just what can you say about the way he's able to continue to bring this level of play?
Well, and he's such a great two-way player. You don't think, I mean, look at the players up there. Not that they don't play defense either, but turns it all, and he's not flashy. He's an incredible captain. He just feels like he's been around forever, and obviously just gets it done both ends of the ice, and he's an incredible leader. So fun to see his name up there on that board, and not surprising, but when you think of him, you don't think of just offense. You just think of this great, incredible all-around player and leader, and he's been doing it for a long time.
Yeah, absolutely. Helps lead them to another win, a big 2 points for the Kings. We've got a lot more to go here on the Fly. Hope you'll stick with us when we return. March, it's Women's History Month, and on Monday, NHL Network celebrated with a women's edition of NHL Tonight. We'll recap the day, plus we've got highlights from the PWHL when we return.
City takeover to round out this weekend. Here comes Kristen O'Neill. O'Neill with a chance. She scores! Barnett! Kristen O'Neill with her first in the PWHL.
A brilliant save by Levy.
Real good anticipation there against the glove up.
Kept in the zone. Play it again. She scores! How did she do it?
Elmo Rattray.
And they score!
First PWHL goal, and what a blast this was.
And the player of the game, none other than Erica Howe, who just faced an onslaught of shots. Can't stop, won't stop Toronto with 11 straight wins.
Walking in and shot, they score! The captain does it again. Brianne Jenner takes the lead for Ottawa. Daryl Watts gets the hat trick here in Ottawa. Pulls off a stunning upset in front of a sold-out crowd. What a game!
The PWHL's inaugural season has been a rousing success, and on Monday, NHL Tonight traveled to UBS Arena on Long Island for a special show before New York's game against Boston. Let's check out the best from the NHL Tonight Women's Edition.
Welcome in, everybody, to NHL Tonight Women's Edition, presented by Bauer Hockey with Jamie Hirsch. I'm Catherine Tappan, pleased to be with you here at UBS Arena.
I mean, I've just been surprised again and again at the level of support and the numbers, certainly, with people turning out and watching, whether it's on TV or online. All the games are streamed on YouTube, which I think is great because it's just great access that no matter where people are around the world, they can tune into this brand new league that a lot of women have worked tirelessly to create, something that is a true best on best sustainable women's hockey league. I always say this to people, like, I never dreamed I'd do play-by-play, not because anyone told me I couldn't because I was a woman, just because there weren't women doing it. So I never thought, like, oh, that'd be somebody that I want to be like. And so it kind of speaks to the whole idea of this league in general, that if you can see it, you can be it.
Well, it's just, as you said, it's incredible. It's just amazing for these women to have this opportunity be playing games and meaningful games night after night and practices, and it's just an incredible thing for our sport. And not only that, the exposure for little girls to see their idols every night on TV.
We've been teaching our kids that they can't say can't, and I'm living proof of that along with all my counterparts. Just, this is beyond all of our wildest dreams, I think. And so for my kids to get to be a part of it, my daughter still is a little young, but my son is excited he's coming to the game tonight. He loves coming to the locker room afterwards. And I think it's really cool for my son to grow up with so many strong women in his life, and it's just normal to him.
I think just seeing people show up and seeing our product and what we can provide, but also knowing that it's so much bigger than ourselves. And that reminder, you know, our season's been ups and downs. We're fighting for some wins right now, but when we come out on the ice and see those little girls or anyone who's coming to our game, it really reminds us that that's what we're doing this for. You know, you get caught up in the results, but also the journey and the history we're a part of this year is the biggest reason why we're doing it, so it's an awesome reminder each day.
But I think the most exciting part is just seeing these little girls in the stands with their signs and, you know, with their families, just super excited. And like, a lot of their signs are like, we're drafting in 2034. And so I think that's the most exciting part, especially for our players this season.
Boston is passionate sports fans. And so we're so lucky to be in a community that cares about sports, and to be in a hockey community, a hockey hotbed. It's been so much fun. Everything that I learned when it comes to identifying talent, projecting if skill sets will translate to the pro level, how to build a team, how to construct a team, that was all stuff that I learned being with the Bruins and under Don Sweeney, and so really grateful for his mentorship.
It was surreal. Like you said, I was so surprised. There's so many great players who are worthy of this. It's been so exciting and inspiring watching the league kick off and how well it's done so far, so hopefully that's in my future.
Well, I'm sure we'll be calling your name pretty soon for that as well. Congratulations, and go enjoy it.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Awesome show from KT and Jamie. And as for that game, which Jamie was on the call for, we jump to the third period. New York is up 2-1, and Elizabeth Jaeger finds Jade Downey-Landry, who shoots and scores. That was her second goal of the game. New York leads 3-1, and they would go on to win it 3-2. Back to the NHL. When we return, we'll take a couple of looks at Tuesday's matchups that could go a long way in shaping the Eastern Conference playoff picture. That's when we return right here on the Fly. Welcome back. The three stars of the week were announced on Monday, featuring some of the biggest names in the league. The third star was Connor McDavid, scoring 11 points, including 10 assists in 4 games. Second star, Austin Matthews, with 3 goals and 7 assists in 4 games. And the first star was the grade 8, Alex Ovechkin, scoring 7 goals and dishing out 1 helper in 4 games. And the East Conference playoff picture just seems like it's changing almost every day. The Bruins and Panthers are tied at the top of the Atlantic with 97 points. The Rangers hold just a 1-point lead on the Hurricanes in the Metro. And Ovechkin's Caps have now jumped the Wings for that final wild card spot. So, Doobie, that is where we got to go because these two teams will be facing off on Tuesday, and you know that game means a lot for both of those teams. Obviously, this Capitals team right now, they're streaking, led by Alexander Ovechkin, and they want to keep it going. I mean, what can you say about, let's start with Ovi first, just obviously dominant out there, picking up those numbers.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't know how we're getting treated with these playoff games, basically, with still 10 to go, but it's been well documented on the network here on Ovi scoring on me lots. So I know everyone loves to see Ovi score. It was a tough start to the year, obviously, with him not scoring at his usual clip. But this is what we're used to seeing from him. And if this Washington team is going to make the playoffs, they're going to need all that and more out of Ovi, and he looks like he's ready to produce.
Yeah, he's got 18 goals in his last 24 games. Been so much fun to watch, and obviously they're getting the saves too. Yes. From Charlie Lindgren. Yep. Are you just loving this?
I love it. Yeah, he's a guy I've skated with him in the summers in mini, and just kind of a guy that I always loved his game, and he never seemed to really get an opportunity, and he's got an opportunity this year, and he's been a huge part of the Capitals being now in a playoff spot. And you look at even that last game against Winnipeg, 3-0 win. I mean, he had a couple absolute 10-bellers at the start of that game to put Washington in a position to win in shutout fashion. So he's going to have to continue that, but he's been great for Washington, and I'm excited for him. He's a nice kid, and it's good to see somebody grab an opportunity when they get it, and hopefully you can take him all the way in.
Yeah, he's been just owning the net in the month of March, and we're talking about the Caps jumping the Red Wings. Well, we've got to keep an eye on the Metropolitan Division standings overall, too, because the Flyers better watch out. The Caps are right behind them, and they've got two games in hand, and again, just 2 points back for third place in the Metropolitan Division. So that just adds the extra ante. The Flyers will be taking on the Rangers Tuesday, 7 o'clock Eastern. Doobie, do you think the Flyers can hang on to that spot?
There's always drama in Philadelphia, obviously, and you know, with Couturier recently.
Yeah.
But it's exciting. I think they're probably, you know, they're not going to admit it, but they're probably further ahead in the curve maybe than they expected. So I think they put themselves in a great spot, and they're going to be playing meaningful games all the way to the end, and they're where they want to be right now. But you look at that that standings board, and I mean, especially with the way the wild card works in the Metro, there's going to be a lot of weird flip flopping in and out of the playoffs, in and out of that wild card into the top three. So it's going to be fun to watch, but we're going to definitely see some weird shuffling going on and some huge games coming down the stretch.
Yeah, and talk about a huge game. The season finale for both the Flyers and Capitals, that's April 16th, and yes, it is against one another.
Of course,
so, it is. Yeah, right? Like, we've been spoiled, and yeah, we still have a few more weeks to go in the regular season. So I'm just so amped for the playoffs. It's like you're itching for it already.
Yeah, that reminds me of I think it was Philly and the Rangers way back in the day when it went to a shootout, and the winner of the shootout made the playoffs.
Yeah.
And Brian Boucher, I believe, was the one who got it done for Philly.
Doesn't get any better than that. That does it for us, for Devin Dubnyk and our entire team. I'm Erica Wachter. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time right here on The Fly.